Sports. It's in the game.
Big blitz, nobody blocking. Big win, that's a ring and a watch. Strong in when he come in the slot, trying to bend the corner, your limbs game, then your twin game. All you wanna do is talk, I don't need talk.
I don't hear somebody talk.
I can pull up with that, Chewbacca that. Banging my chest and my head on the lock. Feeling like walking flock of flame, I put that.
So I'm back with my brother and together.
Came from my money is silly. I feel the envy, not trying to be friendly. It is what it is. If you want me, come get me. Whenever you ready, no, I keep it steady. Yeah, I get the W, throw the confetti. Please do not tempt me, don't hold it against me. We about that action, don't ever forget it. Squad of gorillas, the army, the navy. When I call a play, I'ma score like I'm Brady. The title is mine, if you want it, come take it. I'm ready for more. Tell them I'm ready for more. I'm ready for war.
AT&T Stadium in Houston, Texas. This is Madden Football on EA Sports.
Here's Will Lutz ready to get this one started. And off we go on EA Sports. This is Tony Pollard. And able to get this out to the 25. For the first time with Tony Pollard. And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7 past the 30 to the 32. Now you often say that sort of opens the playbook now, second and short. What do you think, early shot here?
I like where you're going. Obviously, we've been together for a while because you know me. I want to take that shot early and loosen things up.
Now the first carry for Ezekiel Elliott. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And they'll get this being stopped just before the 35. A big pickup there on the run.
You know, I have a pretty good friend, Charles Davis, who tells me that when he sees plays like that, strong runs to the right, reminds him of the 1960s Green Bay Packers.
Boy, those were the days back when the fullback actually carried the ball as well as blocked. Then you had a halfback. You had pulling guards, guys who could get out and run. And you can hear the great coach saying it back then. So we get a seal here. And a seal here, and we run this play right in the alley.
A good run, got 7 on first. Here's 2nd and 3. Now a shotgun handoff to Pollard, and he'll be a couple yards shy of the red zone here at the 22-yard line.
Yeah, once more, strong running, excellent blocking at the point of attack. They've got a nice little drive brewing right here.
First down carry by Elliott. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown.
22 yards for Ezekiel Elliott.
And the Cowboys take it all the way down the field and score on the opening drive. So they get the ball on the opening drive. They take it in for the score.
And how about setting the tone right away? Everyone talks about wanting to do that, but you always hear it in every locker room. First 5 minutes of the game, who's going to set the tone? Who's going to take control? Guess who just did?
Well, now on the next drive, when you score that quickly or you're scored that quickly against, probably feel like you need to respond.
Yeah, without a doubt. In other words, you've actually put the pressure even more so on your opponent.
This taken in at the goal line. And makes it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. First down, Hill steps away to his left. That's to his running back, it's Alvin Kamara.
He's gonna make everything
touchdown,
happen.
New Orleans. Alvin Kamara, 77 yards. And the Saints are within an extra point of tying this thing up. Well, he's used to running it that distance. Here, he had to catch it, too, before making the run. Heck of a play for the score.
There's not many things better for an offense than a back who is a complete guy, who can run it and catch it. And we just saw him complete a big-time play for a touchdown.
Now, Sean Payton going to say, let's go for two on this one.
They'll try and run with Ingram. And this play is not going to work. He stops short of the goal line, and this will remain a 7-6 ball game.
So what do you think the mindset was there? You can tie it with a PAT here first half. Why go for the lead right now?
The old school mindset says if you have a better team, you just go ahead and continue to try and dominate. There's also a school of thought, if you don't think you're quite as good, you have to try and take advantage of opportunities. And finally, I just think this is analytics coming into the game. Someone saying the more you go for two, the better your chances are of actually getting them.
After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. Now Pollard. And he'll get it up just past the 20 as his guys will go to work at the 21-yard line. Second drive forthcoming here for the Dallas Cowboys. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
And he'll be taken down here at about the 23-yard line. Credited with a 1-yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9. They'll run left with Pollard. And he finds some space past the 25 to the 27.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
And for the Saints here on 3rd down, an extra defensive back on the field. From the shotgun, a give to Elliott. It looks like he's going to be stopped short of the first down by about a yard. And how about this one now? In their own territory, a gutsy call. They're going to go for this on 4th and a yard. And now before they run this play on 4th and 1, we're going to get a break and a timeout. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. And how about this one now? In their own territory, a gutsy call. They're going to go for this on 4th and a yard. And he's not even going to come close to picking up the first. They stop him right at the line of scrimmage. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And it'll be a turnover on downs. So they take a big, big chance here in their own territory, and you think the coach may have some questions to answer?
Yeah, and, you know, normally we focus on the media, right, the social media barrage that he's going to get for this one. How about on his own sideline and in his locker room?
Yeah.
Because I think the team's going to look at him like, coach, why would we go for it there? I mean, no confidence in the defense. You don't like the punter. I mean, what's going on here? You owe us some explanations.
The run only got a yard. Here's 2nd and 9. He'll get about 6 there as he takes this one down to the 24-yard line.
All right, Brad, I know we're in the early going here, but those kind of runs, they're going to open up a world of opportunities for this offense going forward.
Here's Kamara trying to run for it. And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. It would appear Sean Payton's made the decision here. They will go for it on 4th. Here's Hill. He's going to take a shot for the end zone. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. The Saints' decision to go for it backfires. And the Cowboys' defense is going to get them the football back.
Brandon, let's file this play away for later. Let's note this play because, to me, it's not out of the question that the decision to pass up the 3 there, could come back to haunt them later on.
They'll run with Pollard to begin the drive. And he'll maneuver his way forward for about four. Second and six. Following the pickup of four, here's second and six.
At the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a four-yard run, so the offense is going to go back to huddle and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
Well, they came into this game saying it was important that they set the tone and show that they can run the football. I believe that they've done that here in the first quarter.
And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. 52 yards rushing for him as he's got the afternoon off to a great start.
Well, they're making a real first quarter statement with a run game, no doubt.
For those who remember old school football, running it, establishing things, seeing backs find holes, get through them, they've got to like what they're seeing from this unit so far. Right now, they've decided to, as you've said, establish the run game, and they've been successful doing it.
So in Saints territory now, here's first and 10 at the 42-yard line. Play fake. Here's Prescott. Left side to Lamb. And he'll cross over out of bounds right at the 25.
Well, coaches always talk about finding balance on offense. I don't think you get much more balance than this. Big time run, big time pass.
A 1-2 combination looked pretty good.
How about that? Let's see if they can continue to take that kind of a punch, though.
They'll go with Pollard here on first down. And he takes it down to the 10-yard line.
Now, this is an example of breaking down a defense because on a lot of these runs, he's getting past the point of attack, and guess what he's doing? Forcing the secondary guys to have to make a lot of tackles.
And he is into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Tony Pollard, a 10-yard touchdown run. And the Cowboys, they push out in front further. Zuerlein now for the PAT. And it's up. It's good. Our score, 14-6. So that drive, 6 plays, 75 yards. And it was finished off with a 10-yard touchdown scamper. Now after the touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away. On the return, Deontay Harris. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28. Set to take over once again. Out comes the Saints offense.
And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complementary football? Offense take care of the defense, defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup and recover.
He'll throw complete there to Thomas.
And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. They'll run out of the gun with Kamara. And he's going to be down at the 35, gain of 7. So they'll come up after the gain of 7 on a second and 3. A shotgun snap for Hill.
They'll get this out to Kamara.
His second catch, and this one not nearly as electrifying as his first, and it'll bring up third down now.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They've become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
And the Cowboys here on third down bringing in an extra defensive back.
They'll try to run for the first with Ingram. And they'll get this one down to about the 20-yard line. A
They run. It's Mark Ingram. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8. Second and 2. 8 yards the gain on that last run. Here's second and a couple. A handoff. It's Mark Ingram. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line.
I hope we give enough respect to the big guys up front because they have been getting it done on this drive. The holes have been large, and they've been barreling through them, picking up first downs.
Try to pound it in, Kamara. And they'll get this from the 8 to the 5. Pickup of 3.
Well, Brandon, we always know that once you score one touchdown,
you're
without a doubt. And so far today, he's got one, but was denied as he tried to get the second one.
And the ball smack dab on the 5-yard line. Here's second and goal. Now, before the second down play, we'll get whistles and a timeout. That's their second, so they'll have one remaining here in this second quarter. We'll be right back. Kamara trying again. And not a whole lot there. He does get a couple, taking it from the 5 down to the 3. From the 3 now, here they come on 3rd and goal. Ingram. And he gets halfway there, down to the 1-yard line. The Cowboys going to use their second timeout now. That's their second, so they'll have one remaining here in this second quarter. We'll be right back. The offense is staying out there. Here we go on 4th and goal from the 1. From the gun, here's Hill. And he's got it. Touchdown, Saints. Alvin Kamara with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Saints move back within a couple of the lead. Big 4th down conversion for the score and the defense. That is a tough pill to swallow.
Big time for them. How about them just deciding to go for it on 4th down? And, forget the field goal, because that looked like an easy 3 points. Yeah, you might have had a defensive breakdown in there, but they pressed the issue and found a way to get it into the end zone. Give them big credit for that.
They'll turn to Kamara. And he got it on the touchdown run, but he won't get in here. He'll be stopped short, and they'll come up empty on the try for 2. So now, Charles, 2 touchdowns, 2 tries at 2-point conversions, and both fail.
And you want to say, let's go ahead and run the kicker out there from now on, but the problem is you're chasing points at this stage. So now you've got to dial up more 2-point conversions and hope you're successful from here on out.
After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. Now Pollard. And he will make it to the 20-yard line and no further. There again is the running back as he trots onto the field. And he's well on his way to a 100-yard game. He's already more than halfway there. We're only in the second quarter.
And what I've always loved about running backs is they'll tell you, I had no idea how many yards I had.
Right.
Those guys have an innate sense of where they are in a ball game and how many yards they've accumulated, because you know they're always working towards 100.
He's been working well towards 100 here. They go back to Pollard on 2nd down. And that didn't fool anybody. He's going to be dropped in the backfield. 1:58 left to play till we hit halftime. Coming up at halftime in a little less than 2 minutes, we'll send you to Orlando where Jonathan Coachman is standing by. He'll have highlights and analysis of this first half. Letting one fly deep for Cooper. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. Touchdown, Cowboys! Amari Cooper, 79 yards. And the Cowboys will extend their lead.
Well, you know he can be explosive, and he's ultra-explosive there on the fly route.
And you know how many times we've talked to coaches, and we've had quoted back to us, well, you know something? When you execute really well, it doesn't matter if they know it's coming or not. But sometimes athleticism beats you as well. He just took off and went. And that's almost like one of your Turkey Bowl games, isn't it? Just go long,
backyard.
Man. I'll hit you. And it worked really well for them.
Now after the touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away. Here's Harris to return it. And they will wrangle him down a couple yards shy of the 30. Spotlight turning back to Taysom Hill as he trots out with his offense.
You know, normally he's probably happy with how he's playing. He's playing pretty well, but in the second quarter, you look up, your team's losing. I don't think any quarterback's satisfied.
Not at all, and what they're really seeking is, how do I play even better and inspire my teammates to do exactly the same in order for us to get back on top on the scoreboard? That's when you find out you have a quarterback. If they're just satisfied with their stat line,
they're not really a leader.
Not at all. You just have a guy playing the position.
Nice work to get seven out of that, and it's second down. Hill now to throw. And his throw is incomplete.
It certainly didn't appear that that's where he wanted to go with the ball initially, so he tried to get something out of it by dumping it off to his running back unsuccessfully.
So the incomplete pass on the last play, and that leads us to a third and three. To throw is Hill. They'll set up the screen now to Kamara. And he's going to have a first down as he's brought down at the 44-yard line.
A first and 10 here. You know, if they could just get three out of this, something about whittling it to a one-score game at half that might provide a psychological boost.
Back to throw, Hill. That's caught by Marquez Callaway. Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. Now the Saints will use their third and final timeout as the clock stops here with 46 seconds remaining in the first half. On first down, it's Hill. That's complete to his running back, Kamara. He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20.
This has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
To throw on first. And it's caught. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. Alvin Kamara on his way to a monster game. Three first half touchdowns. And the Saints get a late score here in the final minute of the first half.
I think everyone in the league talks about finishing, don't they? Doesn't matter whether it's a quarter, a half, a game, a series, whatever. But they're finishing the first half in fine style, putting that one in the end zone.
They did, and they didn't leave much time on the clock either. Well done.
Hill looking to throw for it. That's caught. And he will find the end zone again. So he gets the touchdown and the two-point conversion, and that'll cut this deficit down a little bit further. Needed a couple yards for the two-point try. They go to the ground game, and it works.
And sometimes it's the exact right thing to do because a lot of teams play you for the pass, so you spread people out, decide to run the football. You often find good running lanes.
Now Pollard. And he will make it back to the 15, and that's it. Good coverage there by the kick team.
getting set to go again as we look at the back heading onto the field again. He's been good. His guys are winning. So far, the recipe working here in the second quarter.
And he doesn't like to just tote the rock. He wants to carry his team on his back. And that's what he's done throughout this game.
Yeah, he's done that. He'll be hoping to continue that trend. On play action, Prescott. He'll find Lamb. That's complete. And they're able to get this one across the 35. And this offense going to elect to burn a timeout with 5 seconds remaining in quarter number two. And you see the clock almost empty, so this is likely the last play in the second quarter. Final play of the half, Prescott. Blitz coming, and down he goes. So we've reached halftime, and you want the third quarter already? No problem. Let's do it. Both these offenses have been in fine form. What will the second half bring us as we are underway in quarter three? Here's Harris to return it. And they'll start this drive just across the 30. Pretty nice work on the return. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And they do trail, but they have a chance to possess the football first to try and do something about it.
And that certainly makes it something of an important drive for them, because is it going to win the game? No, but you have to do something to bring some life to your sideline.
Now on second and 13, Hill, and that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on third down.
Well, so much for getting separation. No chance there. Locked down tight, forcing the incompletion on that attempt.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Play action. It's Hill. To pass there, third and long on your own side of the field. Just couldn't come up with anything.
That's why teams always talk about having to win the early downs, meaning you've got to gain yardage and set yourself up for third and short, because when it's third and long, the odds go down significantly trying to pick up the first down, even throwing the football.
Play clock getting low, so Sean Payton says let's take a timeout. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. Here comes the Saints punter now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. Looking up into the roof, and he muffs it. It's loose. But fortunately, he's able to recover his own fumble, or that could have been trouble.
I know there's no magnet in the ball, but sometimes for the punt returner, after such a scramble, it sort of feels that way, doesn't it? He has it. He loses it. Somehow, ball finds its way back to him.
Atone for his sin, and you know he's taking a deep sigh of relief right now. The Cowboys offense now, they head out for their first possession of the second half. And the points, they have come fast and furious in this quarter.
You really don't want to be on the defensive side of the ball right now, do you? Because you're either thinking, my replacement may get an opportunity.
Your head better be on a swivel.
Totally. Or maybe I just need to get out of the game for a while, because I just can't slow these guys down. They've got to figure out a way to disrupt these offenses. And typically, one guy makes a big play, and that can help change things.
They'll be looking for disruption on both sides right now. Now Pollard. And he sneaks his way forward, only for a couple here. Second down. The last run got a couple here. Second and 8. This thrown quickly out to Cooper. That catch good for 5. It's third down.
It's a game of matchups, and that's why you take your receivers and move them around a bunch, especially your best guys. And when they work out of the slot,
You often hear the coaches talk about how great it is because it gives you a two-way go. You can break out or you can break in. That makes it hard to defend.
Room here to run. And he's going to take this all the way down to the Saints 34.
93 yards for him on the ground now as he has been terrific here this afternoon.
So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. They keep on the ground with Elliott. And he'll manage to pick up about four. It's second down.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time and making it work.
Six yards left on second down. Elliott, toss right. And he's got some space here. And he's going to be out down inside the 20 at the 15.
Boy, where would these guys be without his performance on the ground? That puts him over 100 yards now for the afternoon, and I tell you, he seems to be getting stronger as the day goes along.
And he's going to be stopped up right at the line of scrimmage. So no gain on the play, and that'll make it second and 10.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained, so they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly. He takes us down to about the 12 for a gain of 3.
Let's give a lot of credit to the offensive line. They've been able to move the ball really well on the ground the entire game. And while that wasn't a huge one, that's okay. They'll take them in short, steady bursts.
A dump off to Elliott. And he'll be tackled right on the 10, well short of the first down. They failed once in this spot earlier, but the offense will stay out to go for it on fourth down. There's Prescott. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 14. He's at the 50. He's at the 30.
Yeah, 10. Yeah, yeah, baby. We coming again.
And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown.
Well, I think we all know that turnovers have a way of deciding games. And before you say something snarky, I realize that's not particularly astute. But in this case, how about the evidence right here in the third quarter? They've got the lead, moving the football, things looking good. And then...
yeah, so now a flip on the scoreboard with that pick six. And I don't know, the rest of this second half shaping up to be very interesting. And there's a quick momentum swing. INT return for a pick six, and then the two-point conversion good.
And even if you're keeping your wits about you, you're thinking to yourself, okay, extra point block team going into the game now. All of a sudden you're hearing defense. Everyone's scrambling for their helmets and throwing down their cups of water. That's a great position for them to be in, trying to score against that team. A little bit disjointed.
Here's the Dallas offense now heading back out onto the field. And following the pick six, and they have decent field position in throwing that pick six. We'll see how they attack this drive.
And I think all you say to your guy is, listen, let's just take care of the football a little bit better. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help him a little bit with maybe some really high percentage throws early to let him get settled back
yeah,
in.
But they told him, and they told us, they've got confidence. That's not a problem.
Yeah, not a problem at all. They just want to make sure they get things settled down a little bit for their offense and give their defense a little bit of a chance to rest.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Here's a toss play right to Clement. And unable to get downhill there as he'll take this up to about the 37. Tackle is made by Cameron Jordan. Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. They'll try to throw now. Prescott. And open, that's complete to Dalton Schultz. And he'll be stopped right at midfield. Is going to do it for this third quarter of action. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. The drive continues as they search for a tying touchdown. Here's first and 10. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. That's going to wind up a loss of a full 3 yards on first down. So their task a little bit more difficult now. Second and 13 that they're walking up on. Meanwhile, Dak's throw taken in by Cooper here. And
this is going to be another first down as the tackle's made at the Saints 38-yard line. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it. So it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. 125 yards rushing for him now as he has been tremendous all day long.
Another carry for their leader and a good one. It's crunch time. They'll need him to continue to be productive in both the run and passing game in order for them to try and snatch a victory.
And he'll take it from the 18 to the 15, a gain of 3.
It went right back to him, but he pretty much had nowhere to go on that play.
Yeah, the previous carry looked pretty good. That one, maybe he's a little tired. I don't know.
Yeah, maybe he should have tapped out and had a second back come in and maybe make that run. Who knows?
And they get to him quickly here as he stopped right around the 13. Calling a gain of a couple, and that's going to leave him with a third and about 5. Now Prescott. Flushed out right. And this is caught. Amari Cooper. Touchdown, Cowboys. Dak Prescott hooking up with Amari Cooper. And the Cowboys are an extra point away from tying this game here in the fourth. Don't forget the extra point. It's up and good. And we are tied here in the fourth quarter. Defense. Well, we looked at each other right when he flinched. We knew that that flag was coming.
Yeah, offsides, easy call. Mark off the 5 and keep it moving.
Now Zuerlein on to add the extra point. And we are tied here in the fourth quarter. A 10-play drive that time. And it culminates in a Dallas touchdown. So right back to square one, tied at 28 as he kicks it away. Here's Harris to return it. And he'll go down as this drive will start at the 25-yard line. Out onto the field comes New Orleans. Well, they just gave up the score to tie it. That's the bad news. The good news, plenty of time in this fourth quarter to try to grab that lead back. They start the drive on the ground. Kamara. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. Here's Hill. Out of the backfield, that's complete to Kamara. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. Now a first down carry. It's Kamara. And he'll work this forward for about 3. It's second down.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
From just shy of midfield, Hill. And incomplete on the deep ball. Fair to say the secondary play, whichever side you're on, hasn't really been a glowing exhibition so far, but a nice job there to prevent a long completion.
I agree with you, but at some point, someone had to make a play and try and stop this exhibition of almost speed racing that we've been watching, huh?
Yeah, it has been quarterback and receiver dominated. One of the bigger plays in the game thus far, and the crowd getting into it as we come up on a big third down. Hill.
is caught by Callaway. And he takes this down deep on the Cowboys side of the field. All tied up, less than 2 minutes to go. So it's Saints football as we get you reset. The chain gang hustling to catch up. Here's first and goal from just inside the 10. They'll run here with Ingram. That's a gain of 7, and we'll leave them with second and goal coming up. They'll look to run with Ingram, and he'll take it into the end zone for the Saints touchdown. Mark Ingram able to make it in from a yard out, and the Saints answer back with a touchdown of their own to break our tie and take the lead here in the fourth. A big spot now for the Saints as they'll indeed go for two. Hill now to throw. It's complete. And he is into the end zone. The conversion attempt is good, and that'll give him an 8-point lead here in the fourth. Only had a couple of yards to gain there on the 2-point conversion, and they were able to do it.
And how many teams shy away from running the football in the 2-point conversion? They treat 2 yards as if it were 20. If you're a good team running the ball, go to your strength. Go ahead and push it into the end zone.
Yeah, they did. It worked. So Dak and the Cowboys down by 8, 90 seconds remaining. How will this thing pan out? We'll watch as they come up on first down. They start on the ground with Elliott. And not much to speak of. Call it a 1-yard gain up to the 26.
Well, partner, I don't think it's any secret that any running back wants to be able to see a hole open so that he can gallop through it. But in this case, he had to slow down. There was really no hole there. And he took a big hit in order to get that 1 yard.
To throw, Prescott. Eluding the pressure right. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. Late in the game, defense trying to avoid a big play. He's able to work out of the passing game, turn it into a run, pick up the first, and stop the clock as well.
And you know, in this situation, everything is sped up. The intensity, the thinking, everyone's movement. But for a quarterback, he has to continue to do what we call flatliner, leveling everything he does and read the clock, feel it in the pocket, and go at the appropriate time.
Here's Dak. Flush to his right. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Now Dak. They'll roll him out right. Looking for Cooper, and it's intercepted. Chauncey Gardner-Johnson with a pick. He got out of the pocket there, was wondering what he was going to do with it, but I think he was calling, his receiver was calling for the ball, wasn't he?
He certainly was. The problem, he called for it too late, and when he delivered, they were all over him in the secondary and came up with the interception.
So first and 10 now from the 30. Hill. He's going to loft one deep left side here, and that is incomplete. A lot of scoring. There's not.